Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is our symposium about back to basic. We're sorry to be late. We're looking for the man who's responsible of the data show, but we couldn't find him. My talk is about the vitreous cutter. The vitreous cutter, one of the most important tools we use in cases of vitrectomy. And actually, history of vitrectomy starts by Robert McMurray in 1970. And he started by in his garage, as you can see, by 19 gauge instruments. It was 2.2 millimeters, which is so large. And with the fiber optic 3.3, as you can see, it is very huge. We are reaching down and right now 0.4 mil. And the first surgery was done by vitrectomy by McMurray. It was in April 1972, as we can see, is a very large sclerotomy, and he's trying to introduce his vitreous cutter with these two forceps. It's very aggressive. This is the first case of vitrectomy done in the history, and he's cutting the hemorrhage. It was a case of a diabetic patient, proliferative diabetic retinopathy, with vitreous hemorrhage. This is the first case of vitrectomy. After that came Kerner O'Malley in 1974, and he did report vitrectomy with 20G. And 1990, Dujoin used a 25G. And later on, 1995 is a 23 system. And Fuji in 2002, he used the fully integrated 25G cannula. And 2004, we started the 23-gauge vitrectomy system by Eckert Klaus. This is a vitreous cutter which was used in the old days, as we can see. It is very primitive, and it is formed of this infusion and this part which where it, there is a suction, and as you can see, there is a battery, a ferritic battery, to be used for vitrectomy. Later on, there is another cutter. It is infusion and cutting and aspiration. There are three in one. We don't find this cutter right now. The vitreous cutter works in three systems. Either the guillotine, it works like the guillotine, like this part. It moves, this plate goes down to cut the head or cut the vitreous. This is the guillotine type. And later, this is the guillotine. The plate of the vitreous cutter move forward and backward to cut the vitreous or the hemorrhage or whatever it's using, and the rotatory one and the oscillatory one. This is the guillotine. It moves like this, and this is the rotatory, and this the oscillatory one. The vitreous cutter moves in this way. The plate moves like this. As we said, the guillotine, and there is a vacuum inside. The vacuum pulls the vitreous or the hemorrhage, whatever, in just in front of this port, and this plate cut the parts which go inside, and you can control the cutting rate by the machine starting from 1,000 till 8,000 and 16,000 right now. This is the vitreous cutter. The mode, how it works, either it is electric or pneumatic, like the Constellation and the Acuras, and the electromagnetic, like the Earthly one. And this is the electric one. There is this part which moves like this, so it moves the plate in and out. Nowadays, it is not used, actually. And the pneumatic one, there is air which pushes this part forward to move the plate inside, and the spring pushes it backward. When the air goes in, it pushes forward, and when it stops, the spring push the plate backward in this way. As we can see, air is pushing this diaphragm forward, the plate in to start to cut, okay? And when the air stops, the spring push the diaphragm backward and the plate go back. Usually, this obeys the Poiseuille's law. It is the relation between the diameter of this tube and the length of the tube and the vacuum. The longer the length, there will be less vacuum. the parameters of the cutter depends on the cutting rate, port size, port position, duty cycle, lumen size, and the vacuum. Actually, the vitreous cutter work in this shearing force in this way, like the guillotine, as we said. Actually, during cutting, you should work closer to the retina as much as possible with less cutting rate. If you minimize the cutting rate, this will pull the retina towards you and there will be an iatrogenic break. But you should use a fast cutting rate so it doesn't allow this part to go inside the port to induce an iatrogenic break. So you should have a fast cutting rate when you are very close to the retina. Actually, the fast cutting rate doesn't remove more vitreous. It reduces the speed of the tissues which goes in. It reduces the distance of the vitreous collagen that travel. When you're using fast cutting rate, the travel of the vitreous will be very short. When it moves like this, then the cutting rate stops and open again, so it doesn't pull on the on the retina, leading to development of iatrogenic break. Sorry. As you can see, this is a fast cutting rate. There is short area of traveling, short distance, travel for a short distance. If it is slow, it will travel for a long distance, so it can pull on the retina. There are four principles to remove the vitreous. Don't pull on the vitreous. Don't pull on it. Don't pull the vitreous far up to the probe. Remove the vitreous in tiny pieces. Take it in large pieces. The flow should be as low as possible. Avoid very high flow. This is the right way of cutting. You should cut while you are advancing. Avoid cutting while you are going back. You should be advancing to the retina. Don't go back so you don't pull on the retina, leading to development of breaks. What is port optimization? Port optimization means this port is closer to the tip as much as possible. This is very important because you can shave the retina very easily. As you can see here, this port is very close than this one. This is the new one. This is 0.23 from the tip, and this is 0.4 from the tip. So if you are shaving the retina, this will be very close to the retina. So you can shave any membranes easily without any problem, and with that, you can avoid using any scissors in this part. I think port optimization, one of the most important part in the vitreous cutter. As we can see here, we can shave the membranes which is present on the surface of the retina with this vitreous cutter without the use of scissors or bimanual technique or whatever. We are using a vitreous cutter to do everything right now. We don't need to change instruments every time to go inside with the forceps again for the scissors. No, you can use it for everything. As you can see, I'm using the forceps right now. Here, I'm pulling like a forceps and using it as a cutter. I'm very close to the retina. I'm removing only the membrane without any danger on the retina. It is better for dissectionism. There is a new probe which is pivoted. This pivot will allow to come also closer, because if we have this regular cutter, there will be a distance from this port till the retina. But this part, if you have this pivot cutter, we can come closer to the retina and remove or dissect the membrane easier. There are two-dimensional cutters, or TDC, which is present in the EVA or the DORC machine. It works like this. If you have one plate and two plates is much better, and you will be more effective in removing the membranes. It will double. if you are using a speed of 8,000, actually it is at 16,000 because you are using both parts, two cutting parts. This will cut, and when it moves in the other way, it will take another cut. Like the saw, if you are using two and four. Okay? If you are using 8,000, actually you are using 16,000 per minute. This is only present in the EVA machine for actually for the port, if fully open the port, the resistance will be zero at this part. But if it is closed, it will be the maximum at this part. We have different sizes of 20 of cutters, 20 gauge and 23, 25 and the 27 recently used. It's 0.4 mil and the 20 is 0.5. As you can see, it's coming smaller and smaller every time. They are working on the 30G right now. As we said, the vacuum, if aspiration pressure leads to a larger volume of vitreous being pulled inside the port per cut. When the aspiration pressure is low, there is volume of fluid and tissue entering the cutter tip per second. It will be much better. As regards the duty cycle, the time of the cutter is opened and the time it is closed. If we are talking about open bias, actually it is more, most of the time it is opened. 80% it is opened and 20% closed. Closed bias is the reverse. This is the closed biased, as we can see, it is most of the time closed and less opened. Here is an open bias, it is mainly opened and less time closed. There is 50-50 closed. This is present in the Alcon machine. And if you're using the electric probe, actually you are using only 50-50 duty cycle. In this machine, you cannot control the duty cycle. Because in this type you are using actually spring. Sorry. You can't control this or can't use the duty cycle because it is mainly open because you are using a spring. The air will go inside, push the diaphragm and the plate, and the spring will push it back. So it will be mainly opened and will be closed for a short time. But this cutter, which is called the UltraVit, it is used in the Alcon for constellation, it is using air. Air will push the diaphragm forward, and there is another air which pushes the diaphragm backwards. So it is fully controlled by air. It goes forward and backward. This can be, in this way, you can use the duty cycle. I think this is the best way to use a duty cycle. This is called the UltraVit vitreous cutter. If you can see here, it is 80% opened and 20% closed. Here is the reverse, 20% opened and 80% closed. Actually, we are using this inside the vitreous core to remove as much as possible from the vitreous cavity, while this part is very essential to use it very close to the retina at the vitreous base, because you are closer to the retina, you don't want to pull on the retina, so you may induce an iatrogenic break. So most of the time it is closed. As you can see, this is an open bias. 80% of the time it's closed. It's opened. As you can see, the vitreous is moving very rapid, and this is very important in the vitreous core. As you can see here, the vitreous move very slowly. This is essential to use this very close to the retina and at the vitreous base. It is again open bias. Move very rapid. If you are going to use this close to the retina, you are going to damage the retina different and induce bleeding and iatrogenic breaks. How does the vitreous move around the break, around the opening, around the port? This is a photograph from, this is the tip of the cutter. The part which is in front will move very rapid, and in the back it will move in this way to reach the cutter. So it works here very rapid, and the and the vitreous from the back will move slower. As regards, there is a Venturi pump. This is a Venturi pump. It means the vacuum is created by the flow. The flow of fluid will develop by the vacuum. And there is a peristaltic pump. There is system which rolls like this. It leads to milking of the fluid in the tube in this way. This is called the peristaltic pump. This is peristaltic. As you can see, it moves in this way. So it leads to aspiration of the fluid in this way inside the bottle. This is the difference between the peristaltic and the Venturi. This is direct flow control. This is a vacuum-based control. Flow is constant until occlusion occurs. Here is only vacuum can be controlled flow depends on the various factors. Okay. We're going to discuss different techniques. This technique is used for the vitreous cutter. I am using it like a vacuum or a flute needle. I am pulling on the posterior hyoid face very slowly. You don't need a forceps to go inside and to pull on these membranes. There is a full back cutter delamination. This technique is called full back because I'm moving the cutter backward in this way. This way is very safe for the retina. If you have a membrane like this, you go like this and move backward. So you are folding the membrane backward. There is no danger on this part to induce an iatrogenic break. I like this technique actually. This is a conformal cutter delamination. You go forward like this and start to cut the membrane in this way, but this is very risky. You may traumatize the break in this way. This is a conformal cutter delamination. I'm using this. You can use different techniques in the same way. I'm using as a fold back delamination also. There is a traction membrane in the diabetic patients. You can use different techniques to remove this membrane. I'm using this vitreous cutter to remove the whole membrane without using any forceps or scissors or by manual technique. With the help of all the advantages of the vitreous cutter. As you can see, this is a fold back technique. I'm pulling the membrane backward. As you can see, it is removed. Here is the disc. This is the last video. Here is I'm pulling on the membranes very slowly. You should be very cautious during this traction to avoid any iatrogenic breaks. As you can see, there's a tough membrane here. I'm using the fold back technique. You can make some pulling on the membranes to avoid to separate it from that to be the attachment. It is tough attachment or there is a space so I can go through it. As we can see, I remove almost all the membranes which is present on the surface of the retina without the use of any scissors or by manual technique. Okay. Thank you for your attention.